you were tracking some showers for us there in Santa Fe, Byron.
Yeah, the flood advisory continues for the Santa Fe area. The good news, though, the heavy rains have ended, but not before dropping quite a bit of rain. That flood advisory does go until 6:30 this evening. Still some high flows likely on the arroyos, creeks, and ditches. Keep clear of all of those. Current radar, our live radar, you see the sweep right here happening live as we speak. We're the only station with live radar. Let's check out an hour and a half loop of this radar and look at the heavy rains around Seton Village, southeast of Santa Fe, over an inch and a third of rainfall in a short amount of time. That's why that flood advisory was issued. Things have quieted down in the area, but keep clear of all the arroyos, ditches, water-covered roads. San Ildefonso Pueblo, Royal, you're familiar with that, of course, where Royal's from. A White Rock also seeing some heavier downpours right now. This is working to the west, could work toward the Los Alamos area. And here in the metro, pretty quiet. We've seen the storms pop up over the Sandias. They haven't really made their way into the metro. Around Chillilee, we're seeing a storm right now work through your area. Back to the west along Highway 60, west of Magdalena, some showers that are beginning to fall apart. But overall, a relatively quiet day outside of a few pockets of heavier downpours. And that's exactly what we were expecting for today. Now, your 7-7 planner from tonight all the way through tomorrow morning. Well, outside of a slight chance of a spot shower or thunderstorm this evening, it will be warm throughout the night, mild. Temperatures dropping down to about the upper 60s, near 70 degrees. Big event going on throughout the weekend. Everybody's excited about it. How about some wine, music, wine, more wine, wine, and wine? That's right. That's what it's going to be. I know. I wish I could go. 26th annual New Mexico Wine Festival at Bernalillo, noon to 7 tomorrow. It's going to be a hot one out there. Yes, lather on the sunscreen and take breaks and mix in some water with that wine. Take the Rail Runner too. Don't drive. We can't say that enough. Holiday weekend forecast tomorrow. A hot one, many areas with spotty storms, but a front works into the state as we go through Sunday and Monday, and that means increasing chances of storms, pockets of heavy rain, and cooler temperatures in the northeast. Future Track 7 shows tomorrow mainly spotty activity over the higher terrain in western parts of the state, but watch as that front works into the northeast. Showers and thunderstorms really ripening around Raton and Santa Fe, Las Vegas. Watch out for pockets of heavy rain. Farmington, the Four Corners, Durango, Gallup, Chinle, and Grants. We're looking at spotty activity tomorrow, more active Sunday into Monday. Temperatures will be coming down. Southwest New Mexico, Silver City, TRC, Lordsburg, and Deming. Spotty activity tomorrow. Better rain chances Sunday into Labor Day across the southwest. Southeast, not the same situation. I think Carlsbad, you're looking at a slight chance of storms for your Labor Day. Otherwise, it is just going to be baking. Temperatures near 100 degrees both Saturday and Sunday. In the northeast, we're going to see big changes. Raton, Las Vegas, better rain chances, especially Sunday into Monday and Labor Day. That includes the Taos area. And for Santa Fe, we had that storm work through the area. We're going to have a slight chance of storms tomorrow. Better rain chances Sunday into your Labor Day. And for the metro, looking pretty good. It's going to be a hot one tomorrow. Bernalillo and the Wine Festival. Keep that in mind. We are looking at a slight chance of a late day storm. 69 for the Heights, 65 for the Valley tonight. Albuquerque tops out 93 tomorrow. Keep in mind, a normal high is 86. Sunday, a better shot at storms later in the day. And I think our rain chances go up still even further as we go into your Labor Day. So if you have outdoor plans this weekend, I'm telling you, tomorrow looks like the best day. And really, any of those days, especially Sunday in the first half of the day, looking good. Okay. But if you have a late day barbecue planned for either late Sunday or late Labor Day, well, there could be some issues.
Okay. Thanks, Byron. Yeah.